lovely Fatima Sana Shaikh is here. Hello, so wonderful to see you.
Hello.
And I have to say that you're looking wonderful in Thugs of Hindostan. It's amazing. Your whole look, the whole vibe. This is obviously something that you've worked very, very hard on. The initial look and then the whole training. Tell us about it.
Oh yeah, it was very difficult also because I had very short hair when I started shooting for the film. So for them to imagine me as somebody else and in a completely different look, I think they had the vision. So I'm glad and I'm so happy that they casted me for it. Who could have imagined, like I would have never imagined that my second film is going to be with Amit Ji and again Amir and YRF. So I'm very happy. Also, for the film, I had to learn a lot of action. I had to learn sword fighting, archery. Archery, somehow I managed. It was not that difficult for me. But sword fighting and I'm very clumsy as a person. Somehow, Dangal mein jo wrestling thi, I could manage. But here, I was finding it very difficult. You know, because you have to be agile and I'm definitely not agile.
I thought you do yoga, you do you know, all kinds of fitness routines. That must have helped.
Yeah. Dangal helped because I got into fitness post Dangal. So it did help. If I would have done it before Dangal, I would have probably died.
Fatima, we had a long chat with Amir for the radio show and he said something amazing. He said there was a point before Dangal where you almost decided to give up acting. Is that true? I mean, you were so disillusioned. Tell us about that. And now it's so wonderful to see you in such fine form.
Yeah, because I had been trying to get work since so many years, like 3-4 years. I was auditioning every single day and I would just not get even a single ad or a film. So after a point, you know, it was disheartening, but I had decided that acting, or I had at that moment realized that acting could not be my career. It could be a side thing that I'm doing just to be happy, because that's what I enjoy. So I wanted to do something else that will give me money to survive. And I thought of doing getting into cinematography or photography, but still be attached to the industry. So that's why, I mean, Dangal also, I auditioned not with the intention of getting the film. Mujhe laga tha ki ye bhi nahi milegi, matlab wo to reality ban gayi thi meri. So I auditioned it because the scene was good.
And it didn't disturb you that maybe Shraddha was being considered for this one and you know, then eventually you came into it. Were you just concerned with your part saying, wow, I've gotten this, I have to do the best?
I'm so glad that other people didn't choose or didn't get it. I'm lucky. I'm very happy that I got the film. So I'm not thinking about all of those things. I'm just very happy that I got to play that part and to be a part of such a big film.
That's the nicest answer I've ever heard. So cool. The archery, I mean, I've seen a video where you're actually showing your wounds, your bruises. How did that happen? I mean, it looks quite an ordeal.
Yeah, it's quite painful. So when you are learning archery and if your form is not correct, the string of the bow, it hits your skin and the arm. But it constantly hit ho ho ke ho. Wo jaise elastic mein hum karte to kitna dard hota hai na. So basically bow ka elastic to aur zyada dard karta hai.
And how heavy is it? I mean, in terms of kgs or whatever.
Initially, it was light. Also, because I was learning on the professional bow, which we use in competitions, it's very easy. But the actual bow was quite wood, so it was heavy. Kgs, I don't know, but somehow I managed.
And would you tell us a little bit about your trainer? Were they an athlete themselves, an archer themselves?
Yeah. I had to also change my gym ka routine. So Rakesh, jo Dangal mein the hamare saath, unhi ke saath train kiya. Archery also, we had an athlete. Unfortunately, I do not remember his name. Do you remember that guy's name? The archer. No.
But you had a professional archer who actually came in.
We had a professional archer who was teaching me archery. And the other part, all the action part, it was our action director, Lee and Franz. Unhone mujhe sikhaya and it was a very rigorous training and we had to train for 3-3 hours every day so that I could get used to it.
First two films, one with Amir and the second with the great Amitabh Bachchan. The first day that you met Mr. Bachchan, was it at a script reading professionally for this particular project? How was that?
When I first met him, it was actually around the time of the shoot. We met him just a day before. just to say hi because we were going to start shooting the next day. And he was so warm and so nice. He was talking about his experiences in life. Amir sir was also there. Then he was telling him how big of a fan he is of him. And the times when there were 5566 films of Amitji screening at the same time, or Black Me Tikte Bikti Thi. So, you know, he was telling us about all about that. And it was really nice. And the fact that he made us feel so comfortable, I was completely in awe of him.
Lovely. And what really is your part? I mean, I know she's an archer, but how is she part of this whole thuggy mandali? Just tell us about that.
Well, she's a warrior princess. बाकी तो आपको फिल्म देख के ही मालूम पड़ जाएगा.
Obviously, somebody who fights the British. Have you been fascinated by history? I mean, I know, for example, that Amir is very fascinated, Victor is very fascinated by that particular period, not just of British India, but the East India Company. Were you ever curious about that?
I still am. Unfortunately, in school, I have not paid attention, so I know nothing about history. Education was not my forte. So even in the class, I used to daydream and think about other things. But now I started reading books because I want to educate myself. I am reading things about biology and anthropology. So it's, I want to read about history. It'll be my next read.
Lovely. Did you interact with the other cast members? I mean, it's a fantastic cast. I mean, just Ila Ji, there's Zishan, there are these British officers. Just your experience of filming with this entire crew.
Zishan is so talented. Oof, he is amazing. Even Ila ma'am, she's so warm and she's so nice. And, you know, she's been big in music industry. So, you know, when she talks about music and when you hear her sing, it's quite nice. And Lloyd, the guy who played the villain in our film, he is also so talented, and he came all the way from, you know, US, UK, and he spent time with us. So it's been an amazing experience because everybody around me were really talented people. Victor is so good. And when you have a conversation with him, you get to know how intelligent that man is. He knows a lot about everything. I was just completely blown when I started talking to him, and I and he's got a great sense of humor. So
Fatima, you must be so happy that your soul sister Sania is doing so well. I mean, what did you think of Pataka? What did you think of Badhaiyo? And also, you guys went abroad to film together for an ad. Yeah. You know, it's so wonderful to see both of you do so well.
Yeah, I'm really glad that she's doing so well, and she's chosen really good films and good scripts. And she is extremely talented. I am very proud of her.
Tell me about the styling of your character in Thugs of Hindustan. I mean, I find it quite fascinating. I mean, there's a bit of a pagdi. You know, you're wearing a kind of a band. Tell me about the styling.
I think it was a challenge because when I started filming, when I got casted for the film, I had really short hair. So for them to imagine me with long hair and going through the whole process of attaching hair on my head, it was quite tedious. But it's amazing because they had the vision to see me in a different light, in a different role, and in a different personality. So the armor, the bands, everything was just to justify the character and to make the character look like somebody who belonged to that period and to that world.
But it wasn't uncomfortable. Like Mr. Bachchan says that some of his armor was a little uncomfortable.
Horribly uncomfortable. It was superbly uncomfortable because it was leather and I am allergic to leather. So every time I would wear leather, my body would react. It was difficult. It was heavy, and there were cuts and rashes all over my body.
There was a point when Mr. Bachchan, was a little unwell. He got hurt. What was the mood like in the unit? Were you guys must have been pretty worried?
Yeah, we were worried about him and concerned because he's a, you know, he is somebody who brings in energy to the set. When he comes, you know, he's very he makes us laugh, he's got a good mood, and it was very disturbing to see him in pain. But he is so great that even in spite of being in pain, he was on set.
Now, you're not really featuring in the songs. I mean, in Vashmalle, you're there, but Katrina has just done such an amazing job in Suraiya, and you know, the bits that we've seen. It must be fascinating to see an actress who you know, we've all pretty much grown up watching, and the beauty and the elegance with which she does all the dancing.
Yeah, everybody knows how great of a dancer that she is. She's extremely hardworking, and I've seen her working really hard for these songs. She spends 5, 6 hours every day just to, you know, ace a move. And it's not easy to do a Prabhu Deva choreography, but she's done it with so much of grace. So she's really a great dancer. I think she's one of the most talented dancers of our industry.
You know, I know that Sanya is supposed to be the choreographer, but the two of you busting a move together is amazing when I see that on Instagram.
So with Sanya, because she's a dancer, she used to teach dancing. So it's in her blood. So she can just, you know, stand up and start dancing. With me, it's not like that. I have to pretend that I'm a good dancer, because a lot of effort and time goes behind dancing, because I'm very bad.
You're being hard on yourself. All the ladies will want to know what you're wearing today. I mean, you're looking lovely. So your earrings, I mean, do you have a particular stylist or a designer that you like, or do you just mix and match? Who does your styling for you?
Abhi to I'm just coming from home. So everything is something that I bought from here and there, from markets, from, I say, roadside. And earrings are the gift, are a gift from Rushi Manush, who've done costume for Thugs. But otherwise, I've just started collaborating with Ami Patel. She's been styling me. And it's interesting, because all of this is very new. It's a new world. Earlier, I would not think so much. If I had to go somewhere, I would just pick up something and just leave. Right now, I think she's making me look a little put together, appropriate for the event.
Malta, were you part of the shooting schedule? I mean, it looks so fascinating. You know, it's like what Hollywood cinema does, which is these large ships and being blown up and things like that. You experience in Malta on those ships.
The beauty of this film is that it's shot in such a big scale, and it is so grand. But like, I did not realize what would happen when you shoot something which is so grand. You know, we've shot a lot of sequences in Malta, but we had to come back to Mumbai and shoot the closes of those scenes behind a green screen. So all of that is very difficult, because up until now, whenever I've shot something, it's been in a very linear manner. But Malta is so beautiful, and we had built ships there, and they blew up the ships also. So everybody felt a little bad. But it was a little difficult shooting there because of rain and heat and the armor.
And there's also Thailand, I mean, which is supposed to be your hideout and the caves and things like that. So your experience of filming in Thailand?
Actually, Thailand was very easy for us, because we were shooting scenes. And action is a little difficult, because it is difficult. Every day doing action, your body gets sore, you get hurt. So it's a little tiring. But when you're doing scenes now, you don't realize. Your day passes by so quickly, and you're so into the scene. So I think for all of us, Thailand has been very easy, because we were doing scenes.
What's your favorite song? Is it Manzoore Khuda? Is it Vashmale? Is it Suraiya? And why?
Vashmale and Manzoore Khuda. Katrina has done amazing job in Manzoore Khuda even in Suraiya. But Vashmale to I love, because of watching Aamir sir and Amit ji on screen, and their chemistry. It's so good and amazing, and they're so good at it. I just loved watching them.
You know, Amir made a very funny statement. He said, you know, when you work with foreign stunt coordinators, they start from zero. Like, he says, I'm a very good ghudsavar, and I know how to gallop on horses, but they would never let me gallop.
Yeah.
They'd make me do it slow. So your experience of working with them, I mean, they're different kind of professionals. So working with these stunt directors.
Actually, they were shocked that I could do a lot of things, because they're not used to people doing their own action sequences. Or doing it to this extent. We've done most of our actions, all of us. So they were a little happy, because they didn't have to put in so much of effort. Otherwise, if they had to start from zero, for me, it would have been very difficult, because I have a lot of action in the film.
What is the one quality about your character that you really, really admire and love? Your character in Thugs of Hindostan.
The fact that she's strong-headed and very, you know, very strong as a person. There have been, she goes through a lot of thing in her life, a lot of trouble. But in spite of everything, in spite of her past, she is still standing tall.
Beautiful. Just some festive season questions before we wrap. We are bang in the middle of the festive season. What's the one thing you looked forward to buying during festivals, during Eid or Diwali? Is it naya joda kapda? Is it mithai? What is it that you like?
Ek to I love mithai. Wo to fortunately log de dete aise hi. Aap mithai khaiye, to mithai for sure. But I love buying Indian clothes. I love.
What music do you play when you have a party, a festival party at home? Don't say like Amir koi music nahi bajta, main poker khelta hu.
नहीं नहीं मैं एक्चुअली म्यूजिक नहीं बजता है हम लोग इतने बातों में ये हो जाते हैं कि म्यूजिक पे कोई ध्यान ही नहीं देता
व्हाट्स दैट वन प्लेस यू लव टू ट्रैवल ड्यूरिंग फेस्टिवल्स लाइक यू नो यू वांट टू गो समवेयर ड्यूरिंग ईद और ड्यूरिंग दिवाली व्हाट्स दैट वन प्लेस एंड व्हाई
आई वुड वांट टू गो टू कश्मीर बिकॉज ऑल आवर फैमिली इज देयर गो टू जम्मू बिकॉज माई डैड्स फैमिली इज देयर सो माई फादर इज अ पंजाबी माई मदर इज मुस्लिम सो वी सेलिब्रेट ऑल द फेस्टिवल्स टुगेदर एंड नाउ बिकॉज वी बिन लिविंग इन मुंबई सिंस फॉर एवर इवन गणपति या जितने भी फेस्टिवल्स हैं ना हम सब सेलिब्रेट करते हैं हमारे घर में पूजा भी होता है रमजान भी मनाया जाता है सब होता है
सो वेन यू डांस ड्यूरिंग दिस फेस्टिवल पार्टीज इज पंजाबी म्यूजिक और इज इट म्यूजिक फ्रॉम फातिमाज़ फिल्म्स
नहीं आजकल हर चीज का डीजे वर्जन हो गया है तो हम वही सुनते हैं उसी पर नाचते हैं
व्हाट आर योर न्यू ईयर एंड क्रिसमस प्लान्स वेयर आर यू ब्रिंगिंग इन 2019 डू यू नो
नो आई डोंट नो एज ऑफ नाउ इफ आई एम वर्किंग और इफ आई एम नॉट वर्किंग बट बाय एंड लार्ज आई एम प्रीटी श्योर इट्स गोइंग टू बी विद माय फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स
लवली डू यू रिमेंबर एनी स्पेशल न्यू ईयर एनी 2019 2018 17 16 दैट यू ब्रॉट इन
विद मी All of my New Year's are usually with my friends because all of my friends live in different parts of the world. So we make sure that by the end of the year, we come together and spend that day together.
Lovely. Okay, Rehman Saab's birthday is coming out. Your message for Rehman Saab, what do you want to say to him here, Rehman?
Happy birthday, Rehman sir. I love your music and I'm a big fan of yours. I hope I keep hearing your songs and music forever until I die. So just a happy birthday.
I'm very curious to know, you said your dad is Punjabi and your mother is Kashmiri. They obviously had a love marriage. Yeah. How beautiful is that? Where did the acting genes come from?
I think wo it asli life mein wo dono itni nautanki karte hain ki wo mere khoon mein
hai. But one of them must have been some kind of stage acting kiya. You won't know, there's no acting genes in anywhere at all.
No. Wo genuinely bade nautanki karte hain life mein.
Lovely. Listen, you're wonderful. I can't wait to see you in Thugs of Hindostan. Thank you for talking to us.
Thank you so much.